I was unhappy with how my original build in my Talos P1 RGB case review turned out, and apparently so was YouTube, as the entire site had major issues with processing videos and sending them to subscriber feeds and things like that, and virtually no one saw that video when it initially posted compared to my normal releases. Thanks, YouTube. My full thoughts on the case itself will still be contained in that video, so be sure to watch it first if desired. But we're going to take the build to the next level after a word from our sponsor.
The ModMic Wireless can boldly go where no mic has gone before. This microphone can attach to any headphones, requires no additional wires, features very low latency, a dual capsule microphone, 12-hour battery life, and LED indicators on the receiver so you know when you're muted and or when the battery is running low. And you can basically run your entire house without ever losing a signal. What more could you ask for? Learn more by clicking the link in the video description.
This build starts with the guts for my old main rig Zazima that I used from September 2016 until January-ish 2018. This was one of my sponsored rigs from Intel with the Core i7-6900K and ASUS X99A2 motherboard. I loaded it up with 32GB of RAM for now, which I can increase, albeit with mismatched kits, if desired later on. For graphics processing, this rig is rocking currently two NVIDIA GPUs, the MSI Armor GTX 1080 and my old ASUS Strix GTX 970 from my old AMD FX Zarya build that my wife was using for a while. Sandwiched between them is an Aquantia 10 gigabit NIC, as once I expand my network to a bit, I want it to have full access at 10 gigabit to my NAS and things like that. Lastly, at the bottom, I threw in the Elgato 4K 60 Pro capture card. Thankfully, there's a good amount of USB ports on this motherboard, as I will likely need more video inputs in time. The 6900K is being cooled by the Cooler Master ML240R AIO, keeping it stupidly cool under load. Why so much power? Well, this rig actually serves dual purposes. It's replacing my old AMD FX Zarya DaVinci Resolve remote render server on top of my server rack. I'm moving it to Windows, which I know makes some of you sad, but I use a lot of plugins that aren't compatible with Linux, and this is also going to be a streaming rig too. I used to do a lot of PC building and miscellaneous IRL streams over at twitch.tv/eposvox, and I'm going to be returning to that soon, TM. So I wanted a rig that was capable of handling my Resolve remote render workload and a kick-ass OBS stream at the same time, well, you know, together, when I'm working at the workbench. The OS and main recordings are handled on a blazing fast 8ADA XPG NVMe SSD, but bulk storage will be moved to my network storage, as always. The only thing that might really change here are the GPUs. I may end up giving my wife the 1080 and taking her 980 out of her rig and swapping it in here, but for now we're sticking with this. After setting up the hardware and using black duct tape to secure the other side of the panel so that it won't shut on its own, a big issue I had during my review of this case, it was time to get cracking on a Windows install. Motherboard and chipset drivers, OBS, Streamlabs OBS just in case, Elgato and Aquantia drivers, Nynite for my core apps I always use, Core Temp to monitor CPU temperatures since this thing might be running hot. I did run into a weird issue where only the GTX 970, which was in the second slot, would be detected, and the drivers for the 1080 refused to install on this version of Windows. It seems NVIDIA is distributing 10 series drivers that require Windows 10 1809 specifically at the moment, and my Windows installer flash drive was based on 1803. Thankfully, once I got it updated and reinstalled the drivers, both GPUs were detected and working. Nice. The second GPU won't see much use for streaming, as if I use GPU encoding, it's going to be on the Pascal card, but it will help speed up my Resolve renders. Changing my usual settings in Windows and uninstalling or unpinning all the bloatware, and we're good to go. This rig is powerful. In Cinebench, it scored almost 100 points higher than my highest 8700K run so far. It should be great for OBS encoding and CPU-bound Resolve rendering. I'll need to load it up with a couple of USB capture cards or webcams and figure out audio for this setup, but I ended this project on a much more satisfied note than I had left it in the last video. This is one of three streaming setups I'm working on for my apartment this month. Get subscribed for more streaming guides and to see those awesome setups coming soon. I am pretty stoked for them. And while you're down there, click the link to go follow me on Twitch, twitch.tv/eposvox, and maybe give the like button a little bit of love as well. I'm eposvox, and I will see you next time.